Welcome back, baseball fans, to the 69, 70, 71, 72 draft prep. And what we're doing here today, we've looked at three boxes, 69, 70, and 71. We know the 1972 is the new season, completely untouched set. But I wanted to look at transactions that would have occurred at the completion of the 1971 season, leading into 72, and see if I could actually use some, all, or partial of these transactions in my own league. So we're going to begin this little exercise by looking at the transactions in November 1971. At this point in the timeline, the Pittsburgh Pirates would have celebrated their world championship over the Orioles, Steve Blass, in Game 7. They would have had their parade and everything. And what's interesting here is that that would be the last time Pittsburgh would be in a World Series until they faced the Orioles again in 1979, 8 years into the future. And it just happens that the Fall Carryover League is 8 years into the future of the Summer League. So that's kind of interesting. But I'm going to kind of go through transactions and see if they are of any use to me. We'll begin November 3rd. And we'll focus really on the players. And we'll go through these if I see any that catch my eye. And try not to take too much time with this. So, Kubiak for Grzenda. Kubiak's on Las Vegas mainly as a defensive shortstop. And Grzenda is an ascending player on the Blue Jays. And we talked about how they would take this card with a 109 whip. So they have no interest in making that trade whatsoever. Now the Astros can trade Marty Martinez, who they have, to the Cardinals for Stinson, who's not quite in the league yet. And if we pop this open, I don't think Stinson is even ready. Yeah, he's still in the minors, so he's not really even ready yet. So, and then we have some free agent signings here. Then we have the Rule 5 draft here that really won't impact much. Brent Alea was on Colorado. He did very well with them. He's going to stay there. Steve Hubley, I think he has a couple interesting years a little bit later. 72. Well, actually, 72. He's got a 351 on base for Kansas City. Yeah, that's not that big a deal. If the Royals or the A's, you see, fight over that player, it's not going to be a big enough deal. Going down, nothing really exciting stands out. Here's a big trade, though. The Cubs trade Ken Holtzman to the A's for Rick Monday. Well, Ken Holtzman was on St. Louis. He was sort of comped to them when they lost out on Steve Carlton. So he's going to stick with them at least for one more year before he either returns to the A's or the Cubs. And Rick Monday is enjoying life as a Colorado Rocky, so he'll stay there. So this trade will be void. Next trade, look at this one. This is the big deal right here. The Reds trade Tommy Helms, Lee May, Jimmy Stewart for Armbrister, Billingham, Cedeno, Mankey, and of course, Joe Morgan. Now, this of course is the prize at the very end. That's the prize of this whole transaction. However, if I go back to my league, I will find that the Astros aren't quite so hot to trot to make this deal, as that Joe Morgan, they have their 70 card. So they have two more shots with Joe Morgan with a 70 card, at which time then they could trade him to the Reds. But at this point, they're going to hold on to Morgan and Mankey, and this whole trade will be voided. This is not going to happen yet. And the Reds, actually, the Tommy Helms card they particularly like, the 71 Helms, 68 Lee May. Let's just double check the years on those guys. for Cincinnati here. Yeah, Cincinnati. So Helms is 71, and he's got that defense, 1E10 defense. And Lee May's got the 69 card, which is just amazing. So they want at least one more year out of him. This trade may happen next year. All right, next trade, and I think we're going to do this one. The next trade is that the Indians trade Sam McDowell to the Giants for Gaylord Perry, and while Frank Duffy is just a toss-in, I don't even think he's active yet. He's a rookie in 72. He doesn't have to be part of the deal. But I think Sam McDowell for Gaylord Perry would make a lot of sense from the context that Gaylord Perry's had two rough years in San Francisco. And they only bring back Marichal, Perry, and a lefty closer who's very good, Steve Hamilton. So if you have just three pitchers, if two of those were lefties, that would be great. And McDowell and Perry are pretty comparable in 60 with their 69 cards. Let's go up to Cleveland now. Yeah, so Sam McDowell is an ace. So, and Gaylord Perry becomes an ace for Cleveland. I think it's a win-win for both teams. What that does is, it means that the Indians don't have a lefty starter, but they could trade Louis Tiant and create room for a new lefty starter. So I think we got a trade here. McDowell for Gaylord Perry. Next, the White Sox purchase George Orta. The A's release Mudcat Grant. And this is an interesting trade. The Angels trade Dave LaRoche to the Twins for Leo Cardenay. Well, that's interesting because LaRoche went back and forth with the Angels a few times, did he not? Here's Dave LaRoche. California, Minnesota, the Cubs, Cleveland, California again, the Yankees. He really played for a lot of teams. His 71 card is outstanding, as is his 72 card. Do the Twins need a lefty reliever? Because remember, the Twins are trying to win a World Series themselves. And I don't think so. They got a very good Ron Paranowski, who has one more good year. So that one may have to wait as well. And Leo Cardenay is steady enough for the Twins. The Angels trading for a shortstop. I think what may happen is we have a big offseason trade involving Don Sutton and Nolan Ryan, and the Dodgers are going to have a bonus shortstop, Maury Wills. And I believe the Angels are going to trade Jim Fregosi to Milwaukee for Don Sutton, the rights to Don Sutton, and then ship him to the Dodgers with Messersmith for Nolan Ryan and Bill Singer. So they'll need a shortstop, but they're going to end up with Maury Wills. Fregosi's going to be in Milwaukee. They aren't really going to need Leo Cardenay. Ernie Banks gets released. The Tigers trade for Tom Haller. That's not going to happen. The Tigers have another Dodger catcher, John Roseborough, platooning with Bill Freehan. All right, here's an interesting trade. Roy Foster, who we saw he has some good cards coming up. Mike Paul has a good card. Ken Suarez is in Florida, so he can't be part of this deal. And of all these guys that the Rangers / Washington Senators have, Del Unser would be the prize. So would Cleveland want Del Unser to play center field for them? Let's take a look at that for a second, because that's really the only value you have in Del Unser at this point. And it was only for 1 year, and he was lousy. He hit .238, and it was buyer's remorse. And then he went to Philadelphia, went to the National League, and he was mostly known for a kind of a platoon player, and later on a pinch hitter. Ill-advised move. He may as well stay put with the Washington Senators for another year, and then just go to the National League after that. All right, next. Here it is. The White Sox trade Hunts and John to the Dodgers for Dick Allen. Well, guess what, folks? Dick Allen's not on the Dodgers, so he's still with Philadelphia. Womp 'em. So how does he get to the Dodgers, folks? In the previous offseason, he moved from St. Louis to the Dodgers. So we're going to look at his transactions separately. Oh, traded by the Cardinals to the Dodgers for Ted Sizemore. Oh, that would be interesting. That would be interesting. But the Cardinals don't need a second baseman. Oh, they don't even have him yet. That's right. You have to go back to 69. How does he leave Philadelphia? Him, Jerry Johnson, and Rojas to the Cardinals for Byron Brown, Kurt Flood, Joe Horner, and Tim McCarver. Well, the funny part about that is McCarver's still a free agent. Horner's already on the Phillies already. The only principals that can be moved in this deal would be Kurt Flood and Dick Allen. And that might not be a bad idea, because the Phillies already have Darren Johnson at first base, and they don't have a center fielder. How does Kurt Flood do in center field for the Phillies? The answer is, he doesn't. All right. Well, that's a problem, isn't it? So what happened with this trade? Kurt Flood refused to report to his new team. You know what's interesting about that? It would be a case of the Cardinals screwing over the Phillies. And I really like that. You know why? Because the Phillies screwed over the Cardinals for the Steve Carlton, having Steve Carlton be a lifetime Philly and not appear in the Cardinals. So there's some... All right, so Flood basically just has 1 year, right? 69, and that's it? Yeah. So we have one more year of Kurt Flood left. And going back to Dick Allen, here's Dick Allen. He could play for St. Louis, the Dodgers, or the White Sox. That's interesting. Well, we could put Flood on the Phillies. We could put Sizemore on St. Louis, Dick Allen on the Dodgers, and then ship him for Tommy John. That's a lot of moving parts. And he wins the MVP for the White Sox in 72. So I'm thinking that, you know what, we have, which Allen do we have? I believe it's, let's go look at Allen for a second. Dick Allen, 69. So I would say all this can wait one more year. So let Dick Allen play one more year, 1969, for the Phillies. And then next postseason, we'll have a merry-go-round and we can move him around. As a matter of fact, I think the same thing. Let's go back to the transactions. I think the same thing here about Tommy John, too. Let Tommy John play one more year for the White Sox. Let Dick Allen play one more year where he is. Kurt Flood, he's not going to report to the Phillies anyway. Let him just finish his career with St. Louis and call it good. So that's what we're going to do. All right, next up. So we're going to postpone and or veto this whole transaction. Hal King is on the expansion Portland team. Casanova's a free agent. None of these guys are of note. The Astros trade Mayberry to Kansas City for a couple guys. Jim York's available, but he's a free agent. I don't know if York has any good years. 71. The 71 York card is the only one that's of any interest. Next. The White Sox trade and get Stan Bonson off the Yankees. Now, we talked about the Yankees wanting Stan Bonson. And what they would do is they would put him in the rotation and get a second lefty reliever. I'm pretty sure the Yankees are going to stick with Bonson for a few years. He's not in the league yet. Let's look at Stan Bonson. His WHIP is 1971. His WHIP is at 1.21 and rotates 3.35. That's probably his best. He wins 21 games the next year for the Chi Sox, but his ERA WHIP's a little bit worse. He's not really that much of a big deal, so I'm not really concerned on a futures. If it's a futures, I'm not really concerned with it. All right, now we have another blockbuster. The Orioles trading Pete Reichert and Frank Robinson, who just would have lost the World Series to the Pirates, to the Dodgers for Doyle Alexander and three other clowns. Well, Doyle Alexander is property of the Toronto Blue Jays, who really need him. They need some talent in Toronto, so that scratches this whole thing. And the Orioles, just let Frankie retire with you guys, man. Pete Reichert's already gone. He was raided from the Oriole bullpen. I think he's on an expansion team. The Cubs trade three guys for Jose Cardenal. Problem is, Jose Cardenal is currently on Cleveland. Remember, a lot of these, when we're seeing guys come up here, there's a good chance their 1969 card is in the Carryover League and it's elsewhere than the team it's indicated. So Cardenal hasn't even got to Milwaukee yet. Shows he bounces around. Here's another. Is Gosger any good? I think he's in the league. Gosger? No, he is not. He's okay in 70. Okay. So as we go back, the Reds trade Granger to the Twins for Tom Hall. Wow, that's a great trade. That's a big deal. So Tom Hall, outstanding lefty, currently on the Ohio Players. The Reds do have Granger. Now, that could be a deal. I could see the Reds want Tom Hall as a lefty in the pen to replace Juan Agosto as the Reds want to win a World Series. And Granger would be going to the Ohio Players in that situation. So that doesn't really help the Twins out at all. Daryl Thomas for Dave Roberts. Not much of a deal there. And some more guys. Here's an interesting trade. The Reds trade Wilcox to the Indians for Ulander. He is currently on Seattle. Nothing going on there. The Cardinals signed Don Clendenon as a free agent. There'll be more trade talks with Clendenon when we get into the Hot Stove League. The Orioles trading Kurt Motten, but he's not on the Orioles. Okay, so this is interesting here. So here's a big trade. The Angels trade Jim Fregosi to the Mets for four guys, including Nolan Ryan. Now, why this is so interesting is that the Angels are going to trade Fregosi in a trade that involves Nolan Ryan, but the destination won't be the Mets. It'll be Milwaukee, who has the rights to Don Sutton. So ultimately, Ryan does get to the Angels for Fregosi through a proxy. So it's Milwaukee, the Dodgers, and the Angels make it a three-team trade. In this period, if we look at the great career of Nolan Ryan for a second, we never had his presence on the Mets because we started in the 70s when he was already on California, you know, and then we moved him to Houston, of course, and then we put him on Texas, even though he didn't play for Texas until the late 80s. We just put him on Texas as a courtesy for the 84 card and gave the Rangers 1 year of Nolan Ryan. If you look at the history with the Mets, nothing really stands out. So I have no real urgent need to compensate the Mets for the Nolan Ryan transaction. Doesn't seem to be that important at this time. I don't find them getting screwed, and they're going to have an outstanding pitching staff anyway. Bill Ramos is not quite good enough yet. Nothing good happening here. Here. He's getting released. All right, and then we have the free agents. Mike McCormick on the Giants. That makes sense. We liked him as a lefty. none of these other guys. These are all younger players. The Angels released Jim Maloney, but of course the Reds have the 69 Jim Maloney. They're going to hold on to him for one more year and probably retire him. He's not even worth playing for the Angels. The Cardinals, a day later, gave Maloney a shot. It didn't work out. And then here's your amateur draft of 72, which isn't really going to matter, because I would just see these cards. If they played as rookies, I would just see them in the 72 set. So there's no big... There's some interesting names in the future, though. Jim Morrison, Warren Cromartie, Rich Dower, Bob Lacy. The Indians released Chuck Hinton. He's currently on the Ohio Players. The Cubs signing Steve Hamilton as a free agent. That's not going to happen because the Giants are going to hold on to him. Ty Cline doesn't do much in this era. The Orioles trading Fred Bean, who's actually, he's pretty good in like 73, I think, but not prior to that. Fred Bean, yeah, 73, he's got a really good card. And to a certain extent, 74, 73, but 72, I don't know if he's got a card with the Yankees or not, but if that's the case, he'd be a Yankee. So it's not a big deal. Let's see. I guess the Pepitone trade's already happened. I don't see Joe Pepitone here. Johnny Callison, who's on the Phillies and was on the Cubs, ends up on the Yankees. He moves all around. I'm not sure if the Yankees are going to want to acquire him in this time frame. Andy Kosko looks like he wants to sign with the Rockies because he's a power hitter. They like home run hitters. The Yankees purchasing Lanier from the Giants, not until Gene Michael's gone. And none of these other players are really that good. Here we go. February 25th, 1972, a day that will live in infamy. The Phillies trade Rick Wise to the Cardinals for Steve Carlton. So, one for one. Now, if we go to Rick Wise for a second, he's actually on Florida. I believe. Well, maybe he's not in Florida. Oh, that's right. No, he is on the Phillies. Well, there you go. Who wants Rick Wise? I could move. It's 69 Wise anyway. Yeah, I could move him to the Cardinals. Let me just check him out and see where he should end up. I don't want Carlton and Wise to be teammates. It doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Well, yeah, the 72 Wise is actually pretty good himself, so I'll put him on St. Louis. St. Louis need a 69 pitcher? That would certainly... oh, there you go. No, I just got the trade. So here's the trade. It's so obvious. The Phillies, since they don't have to trade Rick Wise, they will. They'll trade 69 Rick Wise to the St. Louis Cardinals. Where's St. Louis? Four, drumroll, 69 Kerr Flood. So Rick Wise, wow, you could put Chuck Taylor in the bullpen where he belongs. So they would have Bob Gibson, Rick Wise, Ken Holtzman, and Ray Washburn. Actually, Washburn and Taylor, you can move either of these to the bullpen since your bullpen's gone. Okay. Flood, you lose your center fielder, but he's only a one-year rental anyway. Philadelphia has terrible outfield defense. Right? They have Dave Collins, who they lost. Johnny Callison's right field. He's good. They had Jeff Stone in left field, who's horrible. And Von Hayes, who's gone as well. So they need a center fielder. So, yeah, I like that. So we'll just... The Phillies will trade Rick Wise to the Cardinals for Kurt Flood. I like that. All right, moving on. Padres, Ruben Amaro. And we'll just do... Once we get into April, we'll call it. None of these other guys are particularly very good. Jose Martinez. Mike Fiore for Bob Berta. Here's the trade we talked about before. The Red Sox trading Sparky Lyle for Cater. Well, first of all, Cater has to play for the Yankees first. So Lyle and Cater will be Red Sox and Yankees for at least one more year before this trade happens. The Reds trading Cloninger, the Cardinals for Julian Javier. Don't think I like that deal at all. And let's see here. Tommy Davis. Las Vegas is Tommy Davis. They're going to hold on to him as long as he's good. Because Las Vegas is so short on talent, they need every conceivable hitter they can get. A couple guys are getting released as the season starts. We are now in April. It's opening day. We're seeing more releases and a minor trade here. And then finally, let's stop right here because this is a big trade. The Expos trade Rusty Staub to the Mets for Tim Foley, Jorgensen, and Singleton. We talked about Singleton playing for the Mets this year. Jorgensen's not quite good yet, nor is Foley. And Staub's enjoying life in the Expos. And I think he wants to play there a little longer. Yeah, 69, 70, 71. So we have 69 Staub. And I think we just might improve him to 71 Staub, because that's a 311 average, 874 OPS. So, yeah, we're going to have Rusty Staub play for the Expos at least a couple more years. So we're going to veto that trade there. And then we're into April, and we're going to call it. All right, we're going to call it there, folks, as it's been a long video. Hope you've enjoyed the transactions. I'll try and work this in some of these into my the Fall Carryover League off-season trade carousel before the draft starts. Thanks for checking out these videos. We'll see you next time.